How do we find new planets? So we've known about planets like Mercury, Venus, Mars, Jupiter, and Saturn as long as we've been looking up, as they were obvious objects in the nighttime sky. Bright objects that move different than the stars do. And the way that I can say that we detected them would be with your eye or with direct imaging. So you've directly detected those planets. In today's world, we're searching for planets around other stars, objects that we call exoplanets. And this direct imaging method is actually something that we try as well, just with far more complicated instrumentation. So we haven't found that many planets that way. But there are other methods that astronomers use as well. One of the most popular and productive is called the transiting method. You can see the light of a star dip ever so slightly in a cyclic pattern due to a planet moving in front of it from Earth's perspective. So we watch thousands upon thousands of other stars and we look for tiny dips in the light. Thousands of planets have been found that way. Other methods take advantage of something called the wobble. If you have a big planet around a decent-sized star, the planet will tug on the star, causing it to wobble a little bit. So one way that you can see that wobble is through what we call the radial velocity method. And this is where you take the light of a star and you break it up into its fingerprint. And you can see that light fingerprint move towards you or away from you, depending on if the planet is tugging the star towards you or away from you. Similar to the Doppler effect, where when a car is coming towards you, the sound is higher, and when the car is pulling away from you, it's lower. And the other way you could take advantage of that wobble is something called the astrometric method. And that's where you would very, very carefully watch the position of a star, and you could actually see it jump back and forth due to a planet pulling it towards you or away from you. And while we have yet to discover a planet using this method, there are new catalogs and surveys that will allow us to detect planets this way. We now know of thousands of exoplanets orbiting other stars, and the next generation of telescopes is only going to give us more information and more planets. And we will soon be able to tell far more stories about the diversity of exoplanets in the galaxy. There actually may be another planet in our own solar system. We're calling this one Planet 9. And in order to find it, you've got to scan the entire sky looking for something that moves. And you can log on to backyardworlds.org. It's a citizen science project that I help run, and you can participate in the search.